YouTubers. How are you, witches and warlocks? I am gonna do another ghost stories from the ghost stories deck. And we've heard before the skeleton and the hook. But this story, instead of letting the deck pick, I picked it. So this one we're reading this evening is called Bloody Bones. Now this one, it's a little bit scarier than the others. As you can see, this is four skulls, so it's extra creepy. But let's get into it, shall we? Old Betty was just about the best conjure woman in the Ozarks. She lived way back in the deep woods with a mean old razorback hog she called Rawhead. Rawhead was Old Betty's only friend, and she was quite worried when he disappeared one day. It wasn't like Rawhead to wander off, so Old Betty mixed up a potion to find out where he'd gone. "Where's that old hog gone to?" she asked the potion as she poured it into a flat plate. The liquid clouded over and then a series of pictures formed. First, Old Betty saw a good-for-nothing hunter sneaking around collecting razorback hogs. Then she saw Rawhead slaughtered and hung up for gutting. The final picture in the liquid was a pile of bloody bones. Old Betty was furious. She tried to practice white magic as much as she could, but she knew the dark secrets and when to use them. She pulled out an old secret book and turned to the very last page. Then she chanted, "Raw head and bloody bones. Raw head and bloody bones." Dark clouds billowed from the clearing where Old Betty's cabin stood. Silver lightning left the plate and streaked out through the window, heading in the direction of Rawhead's bones. When the silver light struck what was left of... When the silver light struck what was left of Rawhead's corpse, the bloody bones resembled themselves into the skeleton of a razorback hog. Then Rawhead burrowed his sharp teeth of a panther, the claws of a bear, and the tail of a raccoon. Pulling them over his bloody bones, he went searching for the good-for-nothing hunter. Soon, Rawhead found the barn where the hunter kept his horse. He climbed up into the loft and waited. It was dusk when the hunter drove into the barn. He saw a large pair of eyes staring down from him from the darkness above. The hunter frowned, thinking it was one of the local kids. "What have you got those big eyes for?" he snapped. "To see your grave," Rawhead whispered. The hunter struggled and put his horse into the stall. Rawhead crept a little closer, so when the hunter came out of the stall, he could see Rawhead's bear claws. "What you got those big claws for?" he snapped. "To dig your grave," Rawhead intoned, his voice a deep rumble. Feeling a little spooked, the hunter hurried to the door and let himself out of the barn. Rawhead slipped out of the loft and climbed down the side of the barn beside him, raccoon tail swinging. The hunter saw the tail and gasped, "What you got that crazy tail for?" "To sweep your grave," Rawhead boomed, his voice echoing through the woods. The frightened hunter took to his heels and ran for his cabin, but Rawhead was faster. Just as the hunter reached the porch, Rawhead leapt from the shadows and loomed above him. The hunter stared in terror at Rawhead's razor-sharp panther teeth. "What you got those big teeth for?" he gasped. "To eat you up like you wanted to eat up me," Rawhead roared and descended upon the hunter. The hunter screamed. Then there was only the sound of crunching bone. All right. Well, thank you so much for staying and listening to Bloody Bones. It is one of the 50 tales in the Ghost Stories deck. And if you like this story and want to keep hearing more, hit the like button down below. And if you're interested in continuing to hear more, also hit subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. And good night, witches and warlocks.